Hey everyone, happy 4th of July. Today is the 4th and I'm going to do a little update what's been going on around here. Wow, the pond's doing great. We got a lot of toads. This thing is just loaded with toads. If I could find one, I would show you, but they're no bigger than your pinky finger. They're, you know, maybe even the smaller than that. They're like the size of your pinky nail. Really, really small. You can see here, everything's looking great. All the flowers looking good. My wife's really been taking care of these flowers and watering them. And it's just, I love summer. I tell you, I just love it. Here's one of the toads. It's in the palm of my hand, as you can see. This one's kind of big compared to some of them. But, yeah, they're all over down here. They're just jumping all over, so pretty cool. Yep, strawberries are coming in. Everything's looking good here. We got all along these trees here. We planted strawberries years ago, and they're just everywhere you look, there's a strawberry in here. You can see right here. And man, are these things good. They are so sweet. But we get hundreds of these things before it finally the season rolls out, so. I don't know if you guys know what this is. This is called milkweed. And we try to keep a patch growing in the front of the house here. You can see all the bees and a lot of bugs in this. But the main reason is because monarch butterflies lay their eggs in these. And then the caterpillar comes out of here. And then once we find one of those, we try to get those and put it into a jar. And then we watch the monarch go from a chrysalis into a monarch butterfly. It's kind of cool. Maybe this year I'll try to get that and show you guys that. That is really cool. But what's also cool in here is there's some really cool spiders that hang out. There's one here. He looks a little dead. Something got him. But a lot of spiders in here. And we also have tree frogs that hang out in these too. And if I find one, oh, here's one right here. Check this out. Aren't those cool? They hang out in here too, and they feast on the bugs that fly in and out of here. So, yeah, that's our little patch of milkweed. Yeah, the garden's doing well. These are the raspberries, called everberries, and they come back every year. And my wife has to trim these back quite a bit because we just get so many of them. You can see they're just getting ready to ripen here, and I love these things. They're so sweet, and you can see the corn. Actually did make it knee-high by 4th of July, which was cool. We planted late this year because we had so much rain. And you can see here the tomatoes and the beans, and she has some peppers growing as well as some other beans here, so it's looking really good. Yeah, more flowers. All right, so we've got the pheasants here. You can see they're getting really big. They're really skittish. They don't like people so much. There's one there. Really, really bad news here on the chicken and pheasant front. We have had nothing but trouble with the raccoons and the weasels and I don't know what else, but really bad news on my daughter's chickens. I haven't made an update on these in a while just because it's been just a horrible thing. All of her chickens were killed, all decapitated by raccoons. They got in through this fortress. I have no idea how. We've gone through and secured it up again and again and again, and they still seem to figure out a way to get in. And so we've fixed it now. We've electrified the fence. We have it down here. We have to make it past that to this one. We got that one. Make it past that. We got another one up here. And if you listen close, you can hear it clicking away. 3,100 volts. And you can hear right there, there's a spot here where it kind of jumps the fence occasionally. And the way I have this set up, the fencing itself is the ground grid. And if you touch this wire here, you're going to get jolted. And I'll tell you what, I did it once. Didn't actually touch the wire. I got close to it, and it jumped across and got me. And it's like a spark plug. It is really, really intense. So I don't think anything is going to touch that very often. Maybe once, and that's it. So we're hoping that it's going to do it, because we've lost all of these chickens here. And we lost another one of our layers here. My wife did hatch about 10 more. So we're going to be putting them back in here. And I think now they're going to be pretty well protected with this electric fencing. I sure hope so. We also have more Polish chickens on the way and silkies for my daughter. So like I said, this hopefully this fortress will hold up now. There goes the pheasants. They just, they're really skittish. We're going to keep what we have left. We only have five. We started with 20, and we think we have five or six left. So it's pretty much a shame here. But we're going to keep them through the winter, and we'll try to hatch more next year. Well, we started some work on the field here where we had the food plot. And we're going to put some other seeds out here. The tractor's not running right. We have to take the carburetor off and clean it. Got some gunk in it, so that's what we're going to be doing. Later today, we'll finish this up. We've got some sorghum and some other things that the pheasants like, as well as the deer. I'm going to plant some corn out here too, so that should be cool. I've got my cameras set up here. There's one here. After this video, I'm going to throw up what pictures I have. I have some pretty cool pictures I think you guys are going to like. I'll put those up. So I'm going to grab this card. I'm going to go grab the one in the back, and I'll put the video of put those pictures up in the video here. Yeah, the wild raspberries are getting ready too. This property is loaded with wild raspberries all around here. If you mow them down every other year or so, they come back with and they really produce really well. So I'm gonna head back to the back here and grab my other camera. It's a long walk, but it's worth it. It's a beautiful day today. It's probably around 78 right now. It's gonna get up probably close to 90. Last few days it's been upper 90, so we've been having a lot of fun going out to the beach and just hanging out. We didn't go anywhere this year for the 4th, so yeah, there's Dad's camper. And you can see here the pears. This is a wild pear tree. I don't know how wild it would be, but it's a pear tree. Just grew on its own here. And then over here is an apple tree that also just grew on its own. It produces pretty good apples. But yep, everything's looking great out here. It's nice and green, and you can hear the crickets and the birds in the background. It's, like I say, it's my favorite time of the year. All right, so I have the last camera here. You see I have the solar cell here. I had to move it out of the woods because it wasn't getting enough sun to keep the battery charged up. But this is a good spot. Right now it's in the shade, but as that sun comes around, really gets in the sun for quite a few hours. So been watching this corner here, so we'll see what kind of good stuff we've got. All right, guys, I'm going to change out this card right here and put up the pictures that I've gotten. Got some pretty cool ones, so thanks for watching, guys. All right, guys. I really do appreciate you guys watching, and if you have any comments, you know, put them down below and let me know what you think. I've been putting up a lot of videos lately. Not much to, you know, to do. We've just been having a lot of fun around here, and you know, it's hard to videotape that kind of stuff. So if I do some repairs or something, I'll be sure to put that up. And I do have some repairs to do on the car, and I know not everybody's interested in that, but you know, I'm gonna be putting up anyway. So so anyway, happy 4th of July, everyone, and really, I appreciate you watching. Thanks.